हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. दिस इज प्रोफेसर रौनक हियर, वेलकम्स यू ऑल अगेन इन द क्लास ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मैथमेटिक्स. आई होप एवरीवन कैन हियर मी, जस्ट गिव मी द कंफर्मेशन. गुड मॉर्निंग विद्या, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग ध्रुवी, विराज, अदिति एंड ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स, चांदनी, गुड. Okay, so the functions that you are going to do today, are going to be extremely useful to you. Why? Because those functions are very much practical. These functions are going to be useful irrespective of any field you will be selecting, whether you opt for the finance or not, whether you want to pursue your career in the finance or not, whether you want to establish your own business or profession, whether you want to go to some other fields which are not related to finance, whether you want to expand the business of your father only. In every such circumstances, these functions are extremely going to be useful to you. Sir, how? Let's see that one by one. I'm sharing my Excel screen with all of you again so that you will be able to get it. I hope everyone is able to see my Excel screen over there. Just give me the confirmation by unmuting yourself so that I can move ahead.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Thank you very much. We have completed till the FV schedule. If I give you a very quick review about the FV schedule, that was to find the future value when the rate of interest, the rate of return of interest was getting changed over a period of time. So, if the expectations of the person from this investment, my dear fellas and fellies, gets changed over a period of time, at that point of time, you prepare the FV schedule. Instead of FV, you use the function FV schedule. The primary reason is the interest rate is getting changed over a period of time. So, if you take this example, say in every year, the interest rate expectation is going to be changed. And this is applicable to the various investment options, right? If you take the Sukanya Samriddhi account for the girl child or education or the marriage, if you take a public provident fund, if you take national saving certificates, the rate of interest which you get on these investments gets changed over a period of time. So this is applicable to various investment avenues of yours. That's why FV schedule is going to be extremely useful to all of you. Now, today, the function that we are going to start now is the effective and nominal rate. Now, what do we understand by the effective and nominal rate first? Effective rate, maneke, if I give you a very simple example, say the compounding is happening on 6 monthly basis. And 15% is the rate of return or interest rate which you have from this investment. So if I give you a simple example, say 100 rupees you have invested and 15% per annum you expect from this investment, but compounding is done on semi-annual basis, right? Now, if compounding is done on semi-annual basis, that means you are receiving the interest on semi-annual basis. So you are going to calculate the interest at 7.5% first on this 100 for the first 6 months. And for another 6 months, you will again calculate 7.5% on that amount. Sir, how? So 7.5% of this amount would be 100, right? Multiplied by 7.5%. So if I press equal, if I press enter, then it becomes 7.5. If I add this 100 plus 7.5, it becomes 107.5, right? Now the next 6 months are there. The interest which you are going to receive on the next 6 months will be given to you on this amount, my dear fellas. Try to understand. The next 6 months interest will be on 107 because that's what we have learned from the compounding. It's interest on interest. Okay, so for the next 6 months, the 7.5% you apply would be this multiplied by 7.5%. Your interest becomes 8.06. Now, if you add this 8.06 in this 107.5, your fund value after a year would be 115.56. So try to understand, if your compounding frequency would have been just on yearly basis, at that time, bachchas and bachchus, if you would have directly charged 15% on it for the entire year without doing it semi-annual, then your interest would have been 15 rupees. But here in this case, your interest is 115 minus this 100. So it is 15.56. Here your interest is 15. Here your interest is 15.56. So the amount of interest is getting increased when you increase your compounding frequency. And it would be higher for the quarterly basis. It would be perhaps more higher, not perhaps, absolutely it would be higher when you will follow the monthly compounding. And if you will follow the daily compounding, it would be higher than all. So I hope you are able to understand what I'm trying to say to all of you. So more and more compounding you do, more and more interest you get. So what is the exact effective rate you have got if you do the semi-annual? Exact effective rate you have got is 15.56%, not 15% if your interest was semi-annual in nature. So that is called effective rate. I hope you are able to understand this. Please give me the confirmation so I can move ahead.
Sir, can you repeat the last step?
Which one?
In this 15.56 wala.
Yes. So here in this case, your effective interest is reaching to 15.56. Why 15.56? Because your fund value is 115.56 minus 100 rupees was the investment at the beginning. So your interest is 15.56. Though interest rate is 15%, but that is done semi-annually. And because of the fact that it is done semi-annually, you calculate the interest for two times. First time you have calculated the interest, it is coming 7.5. But the next time when you calculate the interest, no, then it will be on 107. Because in a year, you are getting the interest for two times at 7.5%. So this 7.5% on 107 is coming at 8.6. And if you add that 8.6, it becomes 115.56. Right? So that's why your actual interest is reaching to 115.56 minus this 100. So it's 15.56. So that is the effective rate you have got. The actual interest rate was 15%, but because of the fact that your compounding frequency is 6 monthly, your effective rate is reaching to 15.56%. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. So we have very simple functions for this. No need to, go into such kind of a mathematical problems. No need to solve it manually. Excel gives you the answer very easily. Say your nominal rate is 15% and compounding frequency is semi-annual. So what is the effective rate you are getting? Let's check it out. So equal to effective. Let me change to this. Say nominal rate is coming at 11%. And this is not semi-annual. Let's take it quarterly. Okay, because semi-annual will be already taken. No? So let's take some other example. Say nominal rate you have got is 11%. So what happens effectively is that you will do the katke of this 11%. And the katke of this 11% would come at divided by 4, right? Because in 1 year you have 4 quarters. So it comes at 2.75%. So what happens on first 100 rupees, you get 2.75%, but then for the next quarter, you get interest on interest. So effective rate would be much higher than 11%. So Excel ke andar wo bahut hi easy ho jata hai. Starting with the sign of equal to, This one is the nominal rate given to you. Start with effective rate. So effect is the function that you are going to use it. E double F E C T. Everyone, start using the effect function over there. Effect in bracket. The first argument you have in the syntax is the nominal rate. So what is the nominal rate that is given to you? Can someone tell me here? Very true. So there are two ways to write this 11%. One is straight away you can put this 11% into the formula. Number two way, you can select the cell where 11% is written. So I am selecting the cell of the Excel file where 11% is written. Then to go to the next parameter, we press comma. Then there is another syntax, that is NPERY. Now NPERY maane ke, in 1 year, how many number of periods are there if you follow this compounding frequency? If your compounding frequency is quarterly, then that means in 1 year, you will be having the 4 compounding periods. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Good. I am writing yes, just sir. 4 over there. So write 4. If it would have been semi-annual, I would have written 2. If it would have been monthly, I would have written 12. If it would have been daily compounding, I would have written 365. Yes or no? तर हर बार 365 नहीं होता, कई बार लीप ईयर भी होता है, मालूम है, ठीक है? लेकिन जनरली तो 365 ही होता है ना. Closing the bracket, pressing the enter. So your effective rate is coming at 11.46%. And from the effective rate, if you want to find the nominal rate, then there is again a formula. And the formula for the nominal rate is we have already there, right? 11%. But if you want to find from the effective rate, then how can we do it? Okay, so let me do it over here. The formula for the nominal rate is very simple. Nominal only. So there is one function called nominal. Select that one function, nominal. Right? Then there is an effective rate that has been asked to you in the syntax. So I'm selecting the effective rate, that is 11.46%. Then comma. Then how many periods are coming in 1 year? Here the compounding frequency we have followed is quarterly basis. So in 1 year there are 4 quarters. I'm selecting 4, closing the bracket, pressing the enter. So you get 0.11. And if I convert this into percentage, I should go to home tab. In home tab, I should go to this percentage sign, select that percentage sign, so it becomes percentage. So 11% is the nominal rate. Very simple syntax. There is absolutely no rocket science involved over here. For effective rate equal to effect, select the nominal rate and number of periods in a year. So one more task and then we are going to do this. This task you people are going to do. Okay. Say nominal rate is 15%. Compounding is done on monthly basis. You are supposed to find the effective rate from this. Let me know what is the effective rate you are getting, everyone. Giving
16.08%.
16.08%. Sir, how? Let us see that. Let's verify that. Effect. Opening the bracket. Nominal rate is 15%. I'm writing 15% inside the bracket, comma. So in 1 year, you have how many months? 12 months. So writing 12. Closing the bracket. Pressing the enter. So it comes at 0.1607. And if I convert this into percentage, and if I increase the decimals a bit, so it comes at 16.075%. So I hope my students do not have any doubt in this nominal as well as effective rate now. If you have any, just let me know. Else I'm moving to the next concept. Hello, everyone. Is there any question? Shall I move ahead?
Yes, sir.
Good. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now, in corporate finance, you learnt about the NPV, that is net present value. You are using the net present value principle for your project evaluation. I think the same principle you are going to use in your project management as well, where you are supposed to find the net present value from the project. But the same thing, the same methodology, the same understanding is applicable to your investment as well. You can use this for your projects. If you are thinking from the perspective of the business entity, you can use this function for your personal investments. If you are thinking from the individual perspective, in both the cases, you can use this. What you are generally doing, my dear fellas, at that point of time, you were having the cash flows. You were multiplying that cash flows with the discounting factor. And that's why you are getting the present value. So for each and every year, you are multiplying the cash flows with discounting factor. So for 5 years, if you say you were receiving in 1 year, 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, and then 5. So you are multiplying that with discounting factor. And the discounting factor was 1 divided by 1 plus R raised to N. And you are finding the PV over here, right? So that you were able to get PVCI. Then you are deducting PVCO from that. So that's where you are getting NPV, net present value. Kuch yaad aa raha hai? Aisa kuch kiya tha humne? Aa ki na? Yaad aa raha hai ki nahi aa raha? Sir, aap to bahut question poochte ho. To poochna to padega na, varna kaise maloom padega ki bachche so rahe hai ki jaag rahe hai? ऐसा कुछ याद आ रहा है कि नहीं? नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू फाइंड करते थे?
आ रहा है सर।
गुड सर, मुंह में उंगली डाल के बुलवाते हो, नहीं याद रहा है फिर भी हमें बोलना पड़ता है कि याद आ रहा है, ऐसा तो नहीं है ना? ओके
नहीं सर।
ओके So whatever the amounts that you get over this many years, say if you are getting something for 25 years, and if you will be multiplying the discounting factor for all the periods up to 25 years, no beta, har ek ka discounting factor dhoondne jaoge, to kya ho jayegi? Sham ho jayegi. Aur sham ho jayegi to fir sham ko ghumne ka man ho jayega, to aapka sum fir se adhura reh jayega. To aapka sum ka kabhi bhi ant aayega hi nahi. तो इसलिए एक्सेल के भाई साहब है, उनको ऐसा लगा कि क्यों ना बच्चों के प्रॉब्लम्स को थोड़ी सी सॉल्व कर देते हैं. अगर 25 साल तक हमें दिए हुए हैं, ये तो 25 साल हुए, अगर हमें 50 साल के लिए भी है डेटा, अगर हमें पीरियड है छोटे छोटे क्वार्टरली पीरियड्स दिए हुए हैं, वो भी 50 साल तक, मतलब 50 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 4, मतलब इट वुड कम एट 200 पीरियड्स एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम एज वेल. Our student should be able to do it by applying a very simple formula in the Excel of NPV. The formula of NPV is, now what was the conclusion you were receiving from this NPV formula? Try to understand that. If the NPV was positive, that means your required rate of return was getting satisfied. You were accepting the project. When your NPV was negative, that means your rate of return expectations was not getting satisfied from the project. So that's why you were rejecting the project. So positive NPV, accept. Negative NPV, reject. और obviously negative vibes वालों को reject ही करना चाहिए. Closing the, let me remove this. Let me zoom it up further so that my fellas and fellies would be able to get this properly. So here in this case, what happens that I am a financial advisor of Ms. Shreya Ghoshal and मैं उनके पास गया कि मैं आपका बहुत बड़ा फैन हूँ, तो एक काम कीजिए, आप मेरे एक इन्वेस्टमेंट प्लान के अंदर इन्वेस्ट कर दीजिए. तो बोला, रौनक ऐसी बात है, एक तो फैन का नाम बोलते हो और वापस से मेरे पास से इन्वेस्टमेंट पैसा निकाल लिया. तो मैं बोलूंगा ना, मैं फाइनेंस का स्टूडेंट हूँ तो मैं ऐसा तो करूंगा. तो बेटा कोई बात नहीं, चलो तुम इतना बड़े फैन हो, मेरी इतनी पब्लिसिटी करते हो, मेरे नाम पे इतने पेजेस चलाते हो, तो कोई बात नहीं, मैं तुम्हारे प्लान के लिए इन्वेस्ट करना चाहती हूँ. तो उन्होंने बताया कि मेरे को अभी कितना इन्वेस्ट करना पड़ेगा. मैं बोला, श्रेया मैम आपको है ना 30 लाख रुपए इन्वेस्ट करने पड़ेंगे. तो बोला ठीक है, तो मुझे क्या मिलेगा? तो मैंने उनको बताया कि मैम मैं है ना एक ऐसा प्लान आपके लिए लाया हूँ इंश्योरेंस का, जिसमें अभी आप 30 लाख रुपए कर दो ना, तो मैं आपको कट के करते करते कितने ज्यादा पैसे दूंगा. तो श्रेया मैम खुश हो गए. वो बोला, अच्छा रौनक कितने पैसे दोगे? तो बोला, मैम मैं आपको पहले साल में 2 लाख रुपए दूंगा, फिर हर साल 1-1 लाख रुपया बढ़ता जाएगा, फिर मैं आपको 21 दूंगा, फिर 22 दूंगा, फिर 23 दूंगा, फिर 24 दूंगा, फिर ऐसे करते करते 25 साल तक मैं 59 लाख दूंगा. तो श्रेया मैम को तो फाइनेंस का नॉलेज नहीं था, तो मैंने बताया, मैम मैं आपको बताऊं मैं कितने रुपए देने वाला हूं आपको. तो श्रेया मैम वॉज वेरी मच एक्साइटेड. शी वॉज लाइक, यस 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 प्लीज रौनक टेल मी हाउ मच मनी यू विल बी गिविंग मी. सो आई सेड, लेट मी डू द समेशन, SUM, क्लोजिंग द ब्रेकेट, ओपनिंग द ब्रेकेट. Then I selected all the cash inflows and I did the summation of it, then pressing the enter. I said, Shreya ma'am, I am giving you this, how many mindes are there? I guess 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So I am giving you 90 lakhs rupees. And this one is how much? 30 lakhs. So I said, Shreya ma'am, I am going to give you 92 lakhs rupees from your 30 lakhs, and that is due on katke basis, on every month basis, on every period basis. So she was pretty much impressed with to me, and she said that okay, let's invest. This is a systematic withdrawal plan. But Shreya ma'am has said that her expectations of the rate of return from her investment is 12.5%, because Shreya ma'am was not that much buddhu, you know, she was having some other financial advisors too, and one of the chartered accountants she was having, she asked to him that what is the normal rate of return I should expect. Then he said that you know, at least 12.5% of expectations you should have. Now whether at this you should invest in 12.5% or not, that's the question. So if the NPV is positive from this project, then she should invest. And if the NPV is negative, then she should reject the project. So do we have any formula for the NPV? Yes, sir, we have it. Let's see what is the formula for the NPV. So equal to, everyone would be doing that along with me. No, but you might not be having this amount, right? Okay, so you can write the amount for period zero. Draw the table like this. I'm drawing it along with you. For period, equal to, पहले one लिख डालो, ठीक है, zero से शुरू करते, कोई बात नहीं, चलो, क्योंकि zero year में हमें cash outflow भी होगा ना, 30 लाख रुपए खर्चा भी तो करना है श्रेया मैम को. फिर हमने one लिखा. I hope everyone is there with me. Keep giving me the confirmation so that I come to know that you are there with me.
Yes, we are with you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good, thank you. So, equal to नीचे वाले सेल में करो और one को सिलेक्ट करो, ठीक है? फिर one को सिलेक्ट करने के बाद प्लस का साइन और एक, प्लस का साइन और एक करोगे तो आपको यहाँ पे two मिलेंगे. Some people would be like, sir, ये कैसा खेल कर रहे हो हमारे साथ, जैसे हमें तो मालूम ही नहीं है 1+1 = 2 होता है. तो मुझे मालूम है बेटा, लेकिन आपका मैं काम रिड्यूस कर रहा हूं. कैसे? अब आपको क्या करना होगा मालूम है,
ये आपको 3, 4, 5, 6 ऐसे नहीं लिखना पड़ेगा, आप इसको डायरेक्टली सीधा कॉपी कर सकते हो और नीचे सेल्स को सिलेक्ट करो। सर कहाँ तक करे? सर 25 तक करने हैं, तो यहाँ पे 25 आ जाता है। और अब जहां, अब जब आप कंट्रोल वी करते हो तो आपके पास नंबर ऑफ पीरियड्स 25 तक आ गए, क्योंकि वो ऊपर वाले में एक ऐड कर रहा है। देखो ऊपर वाले में एक ऐड कर रहा है, ऊपर वाले में एक ऐड कर रहा है, ऊपर वाला मेहरबान है तो एक ऐड करने भी वो दे रहा है। सर वैसे ही अमाउंट है वो भी लिख देते हैं बाजू में। अमाउंट में पहले वाला तो है वो तो खर्चा करने वाले हैं, तो खर्चा कितने का करने वाला है? 30 लाख रुपए। मिंडे में गलती नहीं करना, 6 मिंडे आते हैं। फिर हम 20 लाख से शुरू करते हैं, ठीक है? पहले साल में नो 20 लाख नहीं, 2 लाख से 1, 2, 3, 4, 5। सर आप बोलते हो कि मिंडे में गलती मत करना और आप खुद करते हो, तो मेरे हक है ना बेटा, मैं प्रोफेसर हूं, मेरे को परमिशन है गलती करने की। लेकिन आप गलती करते हो तो आपके मार्क्स में काट लूंगा। ये कैसा डोमिनेंस, तो बनो तुम भी प्रोफेसर। सो 2 लाख रुपीज इज गिवन टू यू इन ईयर नंबर 1। सो व्हाट यू आर सपोज टू डू इन एवरी ईयर 1 लाख रुपीज इज एडेड, राइट? सो लेट्स डू सम स्मार्ट वर्क। इक्वल टू सिलेक्ट दिस 2 लाख, साइन ऑफ प्लस, देन व्हाट यू विल डू, कैन समवन टेल मी?
प्लस 10,000।
10,000 की 1 लाख
सर, तो 2 लाख प्लस 1 लाख 3 लाख हो जाएगा।
वेरी ट्रू। सो लेट मी एड 10,000। ओके सो आई इंटरप्रेटेड लाइक इट्स 18। ओके प्लस 10,000 इज गेटिंग देयर। वेरी ट्रू। बच्चे सर की मिस्टेक निकाल रहे हैं, मुझे अच्छा लगा, बहुत अच्छा लगा। तो 10,000 रुपए मैं यहाँ पे ऐड करता हूँ, प्रेसिंग एंटर। अब मुझे हर बार करने की जरूरत नहीं है, कंट्रोल सी करके नीचे 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 सिलेक्ट करेंगे, 25 तक जाएंगे, कंट्रोल वी करेंगे तो हमारे पास सभी अमाउंट आ गए हैं। तो बेटा यहाँ पे थोड़ी सी मिस्टेक हो गई थी, 1-1 लाख रुपए ऐड नहीं हो रहे हैं, 10-10 हजार रुपए ऐड हो रहे हैं। मैंने श्रेया मैम को थोड़ा ज्यादा ही ओवर एक्साइटेड होकर बता दिया कि 1-1 लाख रुपए ऐड होंगे। So this much of an amount is being added, 10,000 rupees, 10,000 rupees, 10,000 rupees. And that can be understood, no? Because I'm a very big fan of Shreya ma'am. If she is there in front of me, then obviously I would go blank. मैंने 10,000 के 1 लाख रुपए कर दिए। तो मेरे पास ये सब अमाउंट्स आ गए। सर अब क्या करना है? अच्छा ये मत भूलना कि यहाँ पे जीरो ईयर में 30 लाख रुपए भी है और वो माइनस में है, और माइनस के साइन को भूलना नहीं है, अदरवाइज यू पीपल आर अवेयर अबाउट द फैक्ट दैट व्हाट सॉन्ग इट विल स्टार्ट सिंगिंग। तो भूल नहीं जाना है, वरना पछताएगा कौन? बड़ा पछताओगे, बड़ा पछताओगे। स्टार्टिंग विद द साइन ऑफ इक्वल टू, हियर वी वांट एनपीवी इक्वल टू एनपीवी। देयर इज अ सिंपल फंक्शन कॉल्ड एनपीवी डायरेक्टली गिवन टू यू इन द एक्सेल। See how beautiful it is, like, and all those, you know, calculations which you are doing, complicated calculations in financial management, corporate finance, and in this project management, everything would be removed by solving the NPV function. Opening the bracket. Now, what is the rate? What is the rate of return expectations of Mishraya? Can someone tell me?
12.5.
Okay, so there are two ways. One, you can select this 12.5%. Another one, you can write 12.5% directly. So I'm pressing comma. So once you press comma, you go to the second parameter. And second parameter tells you to select the values. So yahan pe dhyan ye rakhna hai beta. Ki values aap sirf positive select karoge, negative wale nahi karoge. तो पॉजिटिव कैश इनफ्लोस कहां से शुरू हो रहा है? 2 लाख से शुरू हो रहा है, ठीक है? तो मैं 2 लाख से लेके जितने भी मेरे पास वैल्यूज है सबको मैं सिलेक्ट करता गया करता गया करता गया। अब मैंने क्लोज कर दिए ब्रैकेट को, ठीक है, यहां तक एवरीवन शुड बी देयर विथ मी, जस्ट गिव मी द कंफर्मेशन। अब एंटर प्रेस नहीं करना है। कुछ लोगों ने एंटर प्रेस कर दिया होगा, वो धमाल की तरह, लाल बटन नहीं दबाना था, एंटर प्रेस नहीं करना है। आई एम पुटिंग द साइन ऑफ प्लस बिकॉज वो आपका कैश आउटफ्लो भी तो है, उसको कैसे भूल सकते हो तुम। तो प्लस मैंने किया और कैश आउटफ्लो है उसको मैंने सिलेक्ट कर दिया अब, ठीक है। सो दिस इज हाउ इट वुड बी लुकिंग लाइक, चेक इट आउट। फर्स्ट देर इज अ रेट, देन यू सिलेक्ट ऑल द वैल्यूज एंड देन बाय डूइंग द प्लस साइन यू हैव एडेड द कैश आउटफ्लो। इज एवरीवन देयर विथ मी, जस्ट गिव मी द कंफर्मेशन। यस सर।
यस सर।
गुड, प्रेस एंटर। सो नाउ इट इज समथिंग कमिंग इन माइनस इन परसेंटेज। ओके, लेट मी कन्वर्ट दिस टू नंबर। इज एवरीवन गेटिंग द सेम आंसर? फ्रॉम हियर आई एम कन्वर्टिंग दिस टू नंबर फॉर्मेट। सो माई एनपीवी इज कमिंग एट 9,83,127 इन माइनस। यस और नो?
यस सर।
सो एनपीवी तो बहुत ज्यादा नेगेटिव है, तो श्रेया मैम को मैंने क्या बना दिया? उल्लू बना दिया। उनको लगा कि 92 लाख दे रहा है, मेरा बहुत बड़ा फैन है तो मेरा अच्छा चाहता होगा। लेकिन श्रेया मैम का 12.5% का सपना मैं पूरा नहीं कर पा रहा हूं, तो मतलब श्रेया को ये रिजेक्ट करना चाहिए कि एक्सेप्ट करना चाहिए? क्या करना चाहिए? एक्सेप्ट कि रिजेक्ट? भैया एनपीवी पॉजिटिव है कि नेगेटिव है? नेगेटिव है तब रिजेक्ट, पॉजिटिव है तब एक्सेप्ट। अब इसका सिंपल इंटरप्रिटेशन क्या होता है सर? कि श्रेया की 12.5% की रिक्वायरमेंट को हम सेटिस्फाई नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, दैट्स व्हाई एनपीवी इज कमिंग इन नेगेटिव। आई होप एवरीवन इज गॉट इट। एवरीवन गिव मी कंफर्मेशन। सो द प्रोजेक्ट शैल बी रिजेक्टेड। नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड। तो सर चलो प्रोजेक्ट तो रिजेक्ट कर दिया, समझ में आ गया बात, लेकिन तो फिर आपका एग्जैक्ट रेट ऑफ रिटर्न है कितना इसमें से, वो कैसे मालूम पड़ेगा? एनपीवी नेगेटिव है, प्रोजेक्ट रिजेक्ट कर दिया, समझ में आ गया, लेकिन कोई ऐसा प्लान मुझे दे, कोई इंश्योरेंस वाला बंदा कोई मेरे पास आए और बताए कि भाई तू 30 लाख रुपए इन्वेस्ट कर, मैं तेरे को 25 साल तक 2 लाख से लेके हर साल में 10-10 हजार 10-10 हजार बढ़ाते जाऊंगा, वैसे वैसे करते करते तेरे पास टोटल 92 लाख रुपए हो जाएंगे। अगर ऐसा कोई बंदा आपके पास स्कीम लेके आता है तो आपको मालूम तो पड़ना चाहिए ना कि व्हाट इज द एग्जैक्ट रेट ऑफ रिटर्न यू हैव गॉट फ्रॉम दिस। एंड टू नो द एग्जैक्ट रेट ऑफ रिटर्न दैट यू हैव गॉट फ्रॉम दिस, वी हैव द फॉर्मूला स्टार्टिंग विथ IRR, and there is a IRR function as well in the Excel, straight away, simple, given to you. You are not supposed to do anything. But if you can recall it a bit, the IRR function which you are using in the corporate finance, at that point of time, you are applying the interpolation formula. You are assuming one rate R1 plus NPV at R1 divided by NPV at R1 minus NPV at R2 multiplied by R2 minus R1. So those rates you are assuming first, and then you are applying this formula, and then you are getting the IRR. So again, Mr. Satya Nandela has something to offer you. He said that it's okay.
इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू डू दिस, इफ यू फाइंड दिस वन वेरी मच कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, देन आई हैव अ वेरी सिंपल फंक्शन कॉल्ड IRR. हाउ टू यूज द IRR फंक्शन, लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस टू गेट द रेट ऑफ रिटर्न. So what is the rate we have got? Rate, we can call it actual rate. Shreya ma'am ki expectation ko 12.5% ki hai, lekin satisfy hone wali nahi hai. So starting with sign of equal to, every function in the Excel starts with the sign of equal to. I am using IRR. Everyone should be able to see that IRR. Is everyone there with me? Give me confirmation, guys.
Yes, sir.
Good. Opening the bracket. Good. Opening the bracket, and then you are not supposed to do anything. You are just supposed to select the values for which you want the IRR. As simple as that. Sir, how? Starting with the negative. Here, do not forget this negative value too. Starting with the negative, because IRR wants the positive as well as the negative cash flows. IRR wants the cash inflow as well as cash outflow to find the actual rate of return. So starting with this 30, selecting all this up to 25. So the first parameter of the IRR function we have established, we have completed. Pressing the comma so that we go to the next one, and the next one is guess. Sir, what do you understand by guess? Excel ko hame thoda sa guess karke batana padega ki kahan tak rate hoga. You can guess it like anything. You guess it 50%, 40%, 10%, 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. It's okay. Because Excel is also using try and error system in its programming to solve this question. Just like we use the try and error system for using the interpolation formula of the IRR. We were assuming R1, R2 and all those kind of things, right? That was nothing but the try and error approximation. Here as well, Excel is also using the same methodology, but Excel is doing without even telling to us. पीछे से, पर्दे के पीछे काम करने वालों में से कलाकार में से है ये. इसलिए Excel मुझे अच्छा लगता है. कितना contribute करता है, लेकिन कभी ये जताने नहीं देता कि हमें वो कितना प्यार करता है. Okay, so guess, let's guess 6%. Closing the bracket, pressing the enter. So this is the rate of return which Ms. Shreya is getting. And let me increase the decimals a bit. And if I increase the decimals a bit, so it is coming at 8.04%. So that is the exact actual rate which you are getting from these investments. I hope everyone is clear.
Yes, sir.
Are you all getting the same answers?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Good. By yes, using sir. This... By using this IRR function, you know, guys, you can suggest the appropriate investment to the person. Say, if expectations of the person is coming at 8% only, then why the hell I would tell her to invest in equity mutual funds or direct in the equity? There is absolutely no need to take the risk if her expectation is 8%, because even FD gives you 7 to 7.5% return nowadays. Though the rates are decreasing over a period of time because this, you know, the repo rates are in the declining stage nowadays. But still, 8% we can get over a period of 1 year without taking too much of significant risk. This can be easily achieved. So that is the rate of return which she has got. Okay, let's move to XNPV. Are you all able to see this? There is one project in which अब श्रेया मैम को है ना, वो तो उनका एक्सपेक्टेशन सेटिस्फाई नहीं हो रहा था. मैं बोला श्रेया मैम कोई बात नहीं, चलो आपको 20-25 साल तक नहीं जाना है तो मैं आपको छोटा वाला प्रोजेक्ट देता हूँ जिसमें आपको 2-3 साल के अंदर सब कुछ हो जाएगा. यहाँ पे साल नहीं है, यो 2 साल ही है. देखो कैश फ्लो अलग अलग डेट पे है लेकिन साल 2-3 ही है. 2-3 साल के अंदर सब कुछ कंप्लीट हो रहा है. एक काम करते हैं, अभी से ही शुरू करते हैं ना. चलो अभी इन्वेस्ट करना है श्रेया मैम को. 26 कौन सी डेट है, चलो डेट लिखते हैं 26 अगस्त. 26 अगस्त 2020। मैंने बताया श्रेया मैम, मैं आपको है ना पहला वाला जो रिटर्न होगा ना वो मैं आपको 1 मार्च 2021 को दूंगा। बोला ठीक है, कोई बात नहीं बेटा। मैं मेरे को बुरा लगा बेटा बोल दिया। फिर मैं अंदर गया तीसरे बार में, मैं बोला 2 लाख रुपए मैं आपको देता हूं 1 मई 2020 को। सो शी वॉज लाइक ओके। देन आई अगेन वेंट टू द फोर्थ वन, आई सेड मैम आई विल गिव यू ऑन 1st of July 2020, देन दिस 2 लाख्स आई एम गिविंग ऑन 1st of September 2020, एंड दिस आई एम गिविंग यू ऑन 30th of December 2020, 21 चलो। सो इन जस्ट 1 or 2 years इट वुड बी 21, आई एम सॉरी। एंड लास्ट वन लेट्स टेक 22। सो दिस इज हाउ द डेट्स वुड बी लुकिंग लाइक। सो व्हाट इज द इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ दिस डेट्स? सेट 6 लाख रुपीज यू आर इन्वेस्टिंग राइट नाउ। द फर्स्ट अमाउंट यू आर गेटिंग इज 1,50,000, बट दैट इज ऑन 1st of March। देन अगेन ऑन द 1st of May ऑफ द नेक्स्ट ईयर आई एम गोइंग टू गिव 2 लाख रुपीज। देन अगेन ऑन द 1st of July ऑफ नेक्स्ट ईयर आई एम गोइंग टू गिव 150, देन 2, देन 1 लाख। एंड लेट्स नॉट टेक 6 लाख रुपीज, लेट्स टेक 8 lakhs. I just want to see that what is the rate of return which we are getting, so that you won't be stuck too much. Okay, instead of 6, let's take 7 lakhs. Let's put it over there in minus. Okay, so I hope everyone has got this question. But what is the problem? Why we cannot use the NPV function here? Can someone tell me? Can someone identify this? Why we are supposed to use XNPV instead of NPV in this case? What is the reason? Simply, no, discounting factor को multiply कर दो तो मिल जाएगा। हम यहाँ पे एनपीवी क्यों यूज नहीं कर सकते? नहीं कर सकते वो मालूम है, सत्य है, लेकिन उस सत्य वचन के पीछे का कारण क्या है वो मुझे जानना है। अगर आपकी बुद्धि थोड़ी सी दौड़ रही है इस डायरेक्शन में तो मुझे बताइए जरा क्यों नहीं यूज कर सकते।
पीरियड्स आर नॉट सेम।
ओके, वेरी ट्रू, एब्सोल्युटली ट्रू। द गैप बिटवीन द टू अमाउंट इज नॉट द सेम, दैट मीन्स द पीरियड्स आर नॉट सेम। इफ यू ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस अबिट, द आफ्टर मेकिंग द इन्वेस्टमेंट द फर्स्ट अमाउंट ऑफ मनी यू आर गेटिंग ऑलमोस्ट आफ्टर से 6 मंथ्स, देन अगेन जस्ट इन 2 मंथ्स यू आर गेटिंग समथिंग, अगेन इन 2 मंथ्स यू आर गेटिंग समथिंग, अगेन 2 मंथ्स यू आर गेटिंग समथिंग, बट आफ्टर दैट यू आर रिसीविंग समथिंग आफ्टर 1 year and 3 months। So there is absolutely no symmetry between these periods. The periods are not same. Here in this case, the amounts which you are receiving, see, the period frequency was the same. On every year basis, you are receiving some or other kind of a thing. Again, in year 2, year 3, year 4, we were just assuming that whether we are receiving at the end of the period or at the beginning of the period. If nothing is given to you, we assume that we are receiving at the end of the period. Right. So that means here we do not have the various periods, the same periods. So that's why we cannot use the NPV. Instead of that, we'll have to use the XNPV. Sir, what is the formula of the XNPV? Everyone write this in your Excel file. लेट्स स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग दिस स्टार्टिंग विद द साइन ऑफ इक्वल टू इज इट विजिबल ऑल ऑफ यू गिव मी कंफर्मेशन शैल आई ज़ूम इट अप फर्दर गुड सो इक्वल टू एक्स एन पी वी ओपनिंग द ब्रैकेट फर्स्ट वन इज द रेट व्हाट इज द रेट ऑफ रिटर्न एक्सपेक्टेशंस 50% लेके बैठा है ये भैया 50% तो तेरे को कभी जिंदगी में मिलने वाला नहीं है 50% की जगह पे मैं 15% लिख देता ओके सो व्हाट इज द रेट ऑफ रिटर्न एक्सपेक्टेशंस फ्रॉम दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट द फेलो हु इज मेकिंग द इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ 7 lakhs हिज एक्सपेक्टेशंस इज 15% लेट्स सी दैट वेदर हिज एक्सपेक्टेशंस इज गेटिंग सेटिस्फाइड और नॉट इक्वल टू एक्स एन पी वी ओपनिंग द ब्रैकेट Then first is the rate expectations. So I'm selecting the rate that is 15%. Then pressing comma to go to the next parameter. The next parameter is the value. I hope everyone is able to see that. So what do we understand by the value? Value means all the values of amounts, including the negative one. Why we are including the negative one as well? Because clearly the date is mentioned over there, so no need to worry. Excel is smart enough to understand that what is cash inflow and what is cash outflow. If it is negative, it would assume that it is cash outflow. And the dates are also given, no? So it will not get confused that from where the discounting or compounding should start. So values I'm selecting, including the negative one. All the values I'm selecting. Then pressing comma again. To go to the last parameter. And the last parameter is dates. So I am selecting the dates starting from the first one to the last one. I have selected the dates to closing the bracket. And now you are not supposed to do anything. Just press enter. Your NPV is coming positive. 345.16. So what is the interpretation of this? Who will tell me? Yes, my question is to all the students. What is the interpretation of this? If NPV is coming positive, then whether you should invest or not? My question is very simple and straightforward. Unmute yourself and let me know.
We should invest.
Absolutely yes, correct. You should invest because your return expectations of 15% is getting satisfied. So instead of 15, if the return expectations, if you can put, say, 18%, then whether this project is able to satisfy the 18% per annum return, let's check it out. If I put 18%, the NPV is going in negative. See, 16,219. So if 18% rate of return requirement is there, then you should reject it. If 15% is there, then you should invest because your return expectations is getting satisfied. But not getting satisfied at 18%. So your return is somewhere falling between 15% to 18%. That's what you have understood from this, right? Let's check whether 16% is getting satisfied or not. So instead of 18, sir, if I put 16, yes.
Sir, wo lecture pura, sir. So 15 minutes, 15 minutes extended, sir. Lecture break gaya, sir.
Beta, ek hi minute mein khatam kar raha hu na. Ek NPV bhi khatam ho jayega abhi.
No problem, sir.
Yeah. So you, if you get 16%, then also it's coming negative, right? So that means 16% is also not getting satisfied. I hope it's very much clear to all of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. So everyone, please do it. If you haven't done it yet, let me share my attendance file with you. Thank you.
हैविंग सेशन।